Hi. We'll now discuss the importance of correctly aligning the tube vertically. With bite wings, vertical angulation errors prevent the cusps being superimposed, as well as the correct horizontal angle to avoid contact point crossover. The tube must have the correct vertical angle, especially for bite wings, so the cusps are superimposed. This picture shows what happens when the vertical angulation is wrong. No positioning aid was used. An aid would show up as a gray stripe in the occlusal plane. Minor vertical errors are less critical for periapicals. They'll cause the length of the tooth image to change. This could, however, be important if one is estimating working length for endodontic treatment. Interproximal caries can usually be detected when there are errors of vertical angulation. However, occlusal caries is quite difficult to diagnose on a bite wing, even when perfectly taken. If the vertical angulation is wrong, the crown appears smeared out, and one cannot make a judgment about any radiolucencies that appear at the occlusal surface enamel dentine junction. In endodontics, part of access cavity planning involves measuring how deep the pulp chamber is from the occlusal surface or incisal edge. If you have drilled deeper than this and not found the pulp, you know you are off course. If you are using a periapical for a posterior tooth, and the cusps are not superimposed, as is usually the case, it is hard to tell which cusp to use on the film for depth judgment. With a previous bite wing that should have properly superimposed cusps, you get a much more accurate idea of the position of the pulp chamber in relation to the occlusal surface. Finally, as an example, this image shows how incorrect vertical angulation can substantially change the apparent length of a tooth. In the next lesson, we'll have a look at other technique errors that can lead to poor optimization.